In this tutorial, I'll show you how to configure a Prodys Quantum device for use with the sip.audio service, and how to connect to ipDTL and other sip clients. First of all, you'll need a sip account for the Quantum, so at sip.audio, click on Get sip.audio. If you're a radio station and you need lots of sip accounts, click on Studio and Remotes. If you just have the one device, then click on Individual. Once you have your SIP account at sip.audio, click on the Knowledge Base link in the footer, followed by Hardware, and then select Prodys Quantum. Here you find configuration instructions for all compatible devices. It says log into the web interface for the device using its IP address. You can also configure from the touch screen. Log in with the administrator username and password. Now navigate to Menu, Conf, Audio, and Encoders. Change algorithm to Opus, which is the preferred codec for interoperability with sip.audio, and click OK. Now navigate to Menu, Streaming, Protocol, Address. For Stun Server, enter stun.sip.audio and click OK. Now navigate to Menu, Streaming, Protocol, Server. Check the Register in Server box, and for server IP, we're actually going to enter the domain sip.audio and OK. The auth user is the username for your sip.audio account. Ours is prodys@sip.audio, and we enter the same value for the username. When you created your SIP account, you also will have chosen a password. Enter that in the password box. Now check the Enable Outbound Proxy Server checkbox, and in there type proxy.sip.audio. Click on OK and go back to the home screen, and you'll see now that the device has registered to the SIP server, and we see the 200 OK message. We're now ready to attempt a call to ipDTL. This is our ipDTL account, and if we click in Quick Start, we'll see that our SIP address is myfmstation@sip.audio. In the Quantum, if we click on Call, we can type in myfmstation. It doesn't require @sip.audio, but if you are dialing outside of the sip.audio realm, you would require the domain. And now we click Call. Here comes the call in ipDTL. I can answer. And you'll hear that a loop is set up on the quantum device, so that when I speak into ipDTL, my audio loops back. I can now drop the call in either ipDTL or the Quantum. Alternatively, I could dial from ipDTL to the Quantum. And for that, we just type in its sip.audio username. Again, because we're dialing from the sip.audio realm to the sip.audio realm, we don't need to add @sip.audio. I simply click the connect icon, and you'll see that the quantum is set to auto answer. And again, I can drop the call. If you'd like to find out more information about sip.audio and how to configure different devices, check the knowledge base or our YouTube channel, or get in touch at support@inqualitymedia.com. Thanks for watching.